Amen. 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 Amen.
Good morning to all of you here at the Park Avenue Missionary Baptist Church. We're going to welcome all of those of you who are sharing virtually via Facebook, YouTube. We welcome you once again to the sanctuary of the Park Avenue Missionary Baptist Church. This is Thursday, April 8th, and yesterday, or we normally are on air on a wonderful word on Wednesday, but we had a power outage due to the inclement weather that we had, so we were unable to share in our Bible study the word on yesterday, so we decided that we would come and do it today and get this word out that is so desperately needed. And we're grateful that we're able to be here today and do this one more time. So we're going to pray, and then we're going to get right on into the word. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for this time of gathering. We thank you for your word. We pray, Lord, that you would give us open minds and receptive hearts that we may receive this thy word. Let us not just be readers and hearers only, but let us also become doers of your word. And I pray, Lord, that you would give me what I need, Lord, that I may be able to teach this word with credence, credibility, and clarity. Allow now the very words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart to be acceptable in thy sight, for Lord, you are my strength and my redeemer. It's in the mighty name of Jesus the Christ we pray this prayer. Amen. All right, those of you who have your Bibles, go get your Bibles, whether it's hard copy, whether it's any mobile apparatus that you may share at this time. I want to direct your attention to the New Testament, the first letter that Paul wrote to the church at Corinth, 1 Corinthians, and we want to look at chapter 10, and one verse today, 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse number 31. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31. Amen. I'll be sharing from the New King James Version, and the Bible reads on this wise. Therefore, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. I'll say that again. Paul says, therefore, whether you eat or drink, whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. And one of the things I want to talk about today, and certainly we make it a point, especially around here at the Park Avenue Baptist Church, to God be the glory. Everything that we do, everything that we say, everything that we share in the way of kingdom agenda should be to glorify God. We are committed to be set apart for the glory of God. Our main mission, our primary purpose, our number one objective is to glorify God. Amen. Aim your living at the sole purpose of giving glory to God. We are responsible, watch this, we are responsible to glorify God in all things. It is our responsibility as believers that whatever we do in all things, that we are to glorify God. Everything we should do should contribute to glorifying God. Let us commit ourselves to giving glory to God in everything that we do. It's very important that we understand that. That's why I keep repeating it, because it's not a partial affair. It's not a sometime affair. It's always and all the time. Whatever we do, whether just like what Paul had wrote, whether it's something as mundane as just eating or drinking, whatever you do, do all to the glory of God. Giving glory to God is not adding to God's nature, but is revealing God's nature to the world. We are display windows in which God wants to reveal his glory to the world as they pass us by, just like when you go and you see displays inside of showcasing windows of department stores, and they have items in department stores, retail stores, grocery stores. They put things on display. They put them there to be seen, to attract your attention, that purchasing them would be your number one objective. Well, the same is true as a believer. We are display windows in which God wants to reveal his glory to the world as they walk by and as they pass us by. Matthew 5:16 says it this way, "Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven." See, when we give glory to God, we actually reveal who he is in our lives. God's glory is his reputation to the world. To live for God's glory means this. It means to live so that God's reputation is enhanced, not dismissed. See, my brothers and sisters, you can cause others to see the glory of God, or you can cause others to dismiss it entirely by the personal choices you make each and every day. We are called to represent the glory of God. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3 sets it down this way. God has called us to glory and virtue. And as you live that virtuous, obedient life, you and I manifest the glory of God. What a wonderful feeling to realize that I am the vessel to transmit the glory of God to a watching world, so that whatever I do it all to the glory of God. I'm that living vessel that's used to transmit the glory of God. When people see your goodness, and you living for God, and you doing those things, and being obedient to his word, and following him completely, it is a illumination, it is a transmission that takes place, that they can see God in you, and that's easy, can be easy, attracted to them, that they would ask the question, what must I do? That's very easy to say, but it's more for us to be about doing our Father's business. That's the bottom line in all of our living. Whether something as mundane and routine as eating and drinking, and even at that, it's like even when you're preparing to eat, preparing to receive a meal, it's all to the glory. Where did it come from? It came from God, so we ought to be thankful. And we ought to give him glory, and we ought to thank him in a way that people will see and people will share and want to know just exactly who is it that you serve. Amen. We seek to live to glorify God, not ourselves. It's not for our pleasure. It's not for our satisfaction. It's not for our approval or anything, anything that we need to pat ourselves on the back for. We seek to live to glorify God, not ourselves, and we manifest, here it is, our abilities, our talents, as well as our skills to glorify God, not ourselves. Every talent that you have, every ability that you have been given, every skill that you possess, you receive them from Almighty God. And the goodness is that it's not for ourselves, but we are doing it. We are manifesting our abilities. We are showcasing our abilities. We are sharing our talents and kingdom agenda and skills and everything, even on our jobs, even in school, and whether we're doing something in the community or whether it's even in our own home. Whatever it is, our talents that we're using, whatever skills that we're using, whatever abilities that we're using, we're manifesting them to glorify God, not ourselves. We reverence the basic principle of glorifying God. And here it is, 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19. Paul sets it down once again. And he says this, talking to the church at Corinth. Don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit, which is in you, which you have of God, and you are not your own? For you were bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body, in your spirit, which are God's. Amen. Don't you know, we should have the realization of knowing that because when we became saved, we possessed the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit has set in residence within us. And our body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. And we are not our own. We can't claim nothing. We have not done anything that will possess us to believe that we are all that and a bag of chips or anything of that nature. We've been bought with a price, and that price was paid on Calvary. When Jesus died, he died to save us from our sins. He died to give us a right to the tree of life. He died so that we might be free. And certainly one of the things that is so important that we must never forget, and that is this, we need to always remember, we need to glorify God in our bodies and in our spirit, which was given, which belongs to God. Well, let us be also committed to glorifying the Lord. We need to, first of all, commit your ways to the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. Psalms 37 and 5 shares that. Proverbs 16 and 3 says, commit your works to the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established. Commit thy works. Keep your mind stayed on him. Be about our Father's business. And it says, thy thoughts shall be established. Commit your will to the Lord. Psalms 143 and 10 says, and the Bible goes on and reads, says, teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God, thy spirit is good. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15, we are to commit yourselves to the word of the Lord. Paul says, study to show thyself approved. Amen. Approve unto who? Approve unto God, a workman that needeth not be ashamed, but able to rightly divide the word of truth. You need to spend time alone with the Lord and the word of God. You need to spend time studying, reading the word of God so that you can be able to commit yourself to the word. You can't commit yourself to the word if you don't read it and study it. So in order to do so, you have to pick it up, you have to open it up, you have to read it, you have to study it, you have to meditate. You ought to be, and when you meditate on the word all day long, you shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, and thou shalt not be moved. Amen. Deuteronomy chapter 10, verse 12 says, commit your walk to the Lord. God requires of thee to fear the Lord, to walk in all his ways, to love him, to serve the Lord with all thy heart and with all thy soul. Amen. John chapter 4, verse 23 and 24 shares that we ought to commit our worship to the Lord. Commit our worship to the Lord. Now is the time for true worshipers. And they that worship the Father in spirit and truth need to understand that God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Acts chapter 1, verse 8, we need to commit our witness unto the Lord. And ye shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and the uttermost parts of the world. Listen, it's very important to never forget, always remember. Glorify God in all that you do. Jews had says now unto him, and I'm closing, that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and ever. Amen. To God be the glory. Let us always remember that in whatever we do, whether we eat or drink or whatsoever we do, do all to the glory of God. Amen. We pray that all of you have been blessed with this word today, and we want you to not only be a reader and a hearer of this word, but use this word. And as you go about today and every day and using an opportunity, always remember, someone's watching, someone's looking, and you need to make sure that you glorify God in whatever you say, whatever you do, because it's so important that you will become that display, you become that opportunity that you may be able to be a witness, that you may be able to lead someone to Jesus just by your actions. Amen. God bless you. May God keep you is our prayer. Amen.